Ocarina Sound presents
Young Mozart.
Wolfgang, you must do what I tell you.
Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart is only 8 years old, but his father Leopold has no patience and wants him to improve rapidly. He wants to leave as soon as possible for Italy, the country of music. The Mozart family comes from Austria, from a city called Salzburg. In Salzburg, they have made great efforts to promote their son. But little Wolfgang, who has a lively and naughty character, has fallen out of favour with the bishop. At that time in Salzburg, the bishop was by far the most important person in the town. He had no liking for the child Mozart, who since the age of 4 played many instruments, but whom the bishop found annoying and would not help. By 5 years of age, Mozart was improvising musical pieces on the keyboard of his harpsichord that he would later work up into famous operas. Soon young Mozart was appearing on the stage, first in Paris and then England and then Germany. But Italy must wait until Mozart is 12 and a half years old and has already seen most of Europe with his father, travelling at breakneck speed in uncomfortable horse-drawn carriages and staying overnight in inns, and not always very nice ones. During this time, he has visited the great European courts, kings and queens, and the most important people of the artistic world. But Italy is waiting. In Italy, there lives an extremely important person, Father Giovanni Battista Martini. He is considered the greatest musician of his time. From the world over, musicians go to Bologna, where he teaches musical composition. Finally, the time is right for Mozart to visit Italy. Mozart is almost 13 years old when he arrives in Reverto. His mission is to amaze his audience. Spectators suggest tunes for him to work with. He listens, then sitting at the keyboard, he plays the most amazing music. But he must go quickly to Bologna. In Bologna, Father Martini has already proclaimed his opinion. He has written, "The child Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart of Austria is endowed with great talents. If he studies, he will achieve particularly remarkable results." A statement like this is practically a musical diploma, valid for all of Europe. Father Martini is the master who determines whether a composer is important or not. It is also said that in Bologna, Mozart discovers love. This story is told in the movie Noi Tre. Young Mozart arrives with his strict father in Bologna, but he's unable to practice music because he falls in love with a local girl. The love story ends, and Mozart, with no more distractions, concentrates on his studies and becomes an absolute genius of a musician. In Italy, Mozart also learns about the rare and wonderful thing called cantabile. Cantabile is the style in which people sing delightfully and gracefully, in the street, in any place, solo or in chorus. And here he finds the opera buffa, a form of musical comedy. When Mozart sees it, he is captivated and decides to link his music to this tradition. He finally arrives in Naples, where he is hugely impressed by plentiful and gorgeous oranges growing on the trees and by the sleeping volcano Mount Vesuvius. In Austria, oranges are a rarity, reserved for the rich, and even the jam of this fruit is particularly rare, appreciated and desired. He is impressed by the beauty of the sea, the perfect gulf, a place where when the evening light touches Vesuvio, everybody starts singing. Here he seems to be a member of an orchestra and a choir, stretching from one side of the city to the other. When Mozart is 14 years old, he goes to Milan and plays on the stage of the Regio Teatro Ducale, where his works are very successful. Yet despite his experience, Mozart is accustomed to walk around the Duomo Square and look at the puppets and the actors. Arlecchino, Brighella, Pantaloni. For Mozart, Arlecchino is a passion. Arlecchino wears a mask decorated with spots of different colours. He is a servant who has arrived in Venice from Bergamo, stupid in appearance, but in reality highly intelligent. He solves intrigues and shows how a popular character has an extraordinary power to give the audience pleasure. For Mozart, Arlecchino remains a dream. He wants to compose a play, Arlecchino, Servant of Two Masters, written by Carlo Goldoni, but it is not possible. He does not have time. In his life, everything has to be done in haste, right up to his death while he's working on the Requiem, a Mass of the Dead, which seems to have been written as a prophecy of his own passing. On all his travels, Mozart recalled the most important period of his life, the Italian stay. During this short but packed life, he composed many wonderful masterpieces, resonating with the intense Italian culture that he breathed in before bringing it to the German world, creating a bridge between the two countries.
Thanks to Bertie at Storynory for narrating in English.